At 10:17 a.m. today, millions of people all across the world are going to practice earthquake safety. And here to share why it is so important to take part in this great shakeout, Pat Abbott from San Diego State, professor there. I was just sitting down and talking to you in commercial break. I said, Pat, how have we not had this big one that everybody's been talking about for like decades?
Well, you know, that's the thing about geologic time. You know, we live our lives on a year-by-year basis, but these earthquakes tend to come on more decade at least, or century basis. And so it's really been 30 years
wow.
since we've had a major earthquake hit an urban area. And those are the ones we really remember. When it's in the desert, you kind of pass it off. But when it takes down Los Angeles like it did in 1994, or San Francisco like it did in 1989, those are the things that we worry about.
You talk about San Francisco, and I wonder if our friends at home, there's anybody that was living there at that time that happens to be living in San Diego now. Today, to the date, you said, is the 35-year anniversary of that earthquake that devastated San Francisco.
Exactly. And what was going on at that time at 5:03 p.m., it was a World Series baseball game, the same kind of topic we have today.
This.
Well, there you see a collapse of a freeway with cars trapped underneath it and people killed. The Marina District of San Francisco largely on fire. Boats in the bay are spraying seawater on it. Downtown Santa Cruz, the old heart of it, destroyed by the earthquake. So, I mean, it's a massive event. And it's been so long now that I think it kind of maybe fades in people's mm-hmm. memories. And that's why we like to have these annual reminders of what do you do when the earth shakes.
It's always important to be prepared. How big was that earthquake?
In 1989, it was a 6.9. In 1994, Northridge, it was a 6.7.
The video that we just saw, that was a 6.9?
That was a 6.
And it caused that type of destruction?
It did. Of course, what the earthquakes do is they hunt out and show where bad buildings or bad structures exist. So in other words, not that the whole city doesn't get leveled, but an elevated roadway was bad, but we've retrofitted a lot of those in California since then. Different building codes change after a big earthquake, but we try not to repeat the same mistake that we did in the past.
Significant earthquakes. I remember, what year was it? You're much better than this than me. That here we had one in San Diego that kind of rocked and swayed us here. That was pretty big.
That one was on Easter Sunday there,
about
a decade ago. And you know what I liked about that? It was the first time San Diego's got a real feel for something like going 45 seconds. It goes on and on and on. We're used to it being a few seconds and quits. But the really big ones go on for a long time. Now, had that been even bigger or closer to us, well, then we'd have another replay of a Loma Prieta or Northridge.
Are there any signs, has our technology and our science developed over the years that could give us any prediction of an earthquake?
I sure wish it was so. It's kind of the holy grail of geology or seismology, but we don't know. We can tell you how big something's going to be, where it's going to happen. On a geologic time scale, we can tell you it's going to happen here, but we cannot tell you when. We have zero ability to predict.
So where's that hot spot right now in California?
Well, there's no real hot spot per se, but we have all these mapped faults. We know the San Andreas faults runs right up here from off of the Salton Sea up past Palm Springs through the San Bernardino city limits. We expect that one to go. We know that's going to go, again, not the wind, and we anticipate it could be as large as a 7.8. So that's going to be huge. Is that going to happen? Oh, yes. Is it going to happen this century? We don't know.
You don't know. And knowing what to do is important, and that's why these great shakeouts are taking place. It's important for the kids in school. Most of our kids have never even really been through an earthquake to know like what to do and if you're at work and what are you supposed to do. If there was an earthquake right now, what were we supposed to do?
We were supposed to dive under something for protection. You know, we fear the earthquake because it doesn't make sense. The solid earth beneath our feet, how come it's shaking? The real danger is not the earthquake, it's what's overhead here. What could fall on you and hit you or be thrown at you? So the basic idea is, you know, you dive under the heavy wood dining room table, grab a hold of the legs. We'd say drop, cover, and hold on. Drop under some protection, cover up, and then hold on to the legs so the table doesn't shake away from you. The worst thing you can do during an earthquake, for most people, unless you're in some unusual situation, is don't run around,
don't
move.
Yeah.
You're simply a moving target. Get protection, let things fall. come up with it, you know, full of energy and ready to be a first responder, because there's not going to be enough first responders to go around everybody. Yeah. We have to be in good shape to be first responders for the people around us.
Great advice. Pat, it's always good to see you. We're going to do that at 10:17 this morning. I want to do that. It's just a good reminder to kind of act it out.
Please do.
Yes, we will. And a little later this morning, by the way, the Red Cross is also going to be here to share how you can be ready for that big one when it comes, right?
Very good. Yes.
Thank you, Pat.